was always trying to impress and people please. And then with animals, it was just a lot simpler. I feel at ease, I feel the freedom, and it's just the rhythm, because I feel like I'm really in a flow.
Paul Fowling's relationship with horses wasn't always so positive.
I think my first instance was the Melbourne Cup, of course. And, you know, it was put a few dollars on the Melbourne Cup. I think I would have been around that 9, 10. By the time I was 16, I was gambling on basically anything you could see or know, like horse racing, casinos, you know, blackjack, baccarat, and everything.
Soon, gambling consumed Paul's life, an addiction he couldn't shake.
So even before I get up and have a shower and brush my teeth, my first thought would be, do I have money or where can I get money?
Illicit drugs were Baden Hicks's downfall. He's 36 and started using as a teenager.
I had 18 opioid overdoses. I had the one OxyContin overdose, and but over the last 6 years, I had 17 heroin overdoses. 5 extremely close calls where I, just by luck, I was found.
Baden's drug addiction, fueled by declining mental health, continued. Eventually, the police were involved.
There's about 30 or 40 police in there. Vests and shields and everything surrounded the house. At the time, like, I didn't care. Like, I was like, all right, suicide by cop. End it all, and then put myself out of this misery.
At Paul's worst, he too felt there was no way out. In a matter of days, he gambled away $1 million he'd stolen from his brother.
So, of course, he screamed, like, I don't want to see the f*** out, right? But he also knew that he left with the words of, don't do anything stupid.
Paul lost contact with his brother and eventually sought help for his addiction. Baden's standoff with police led eventually to prison.
I was in isolation for the first 3 weeks. I was struggling with really bad mental health issues. Also, withdrawing from substance use wasn't a nice place to be.
Released 3 months later, it was Baden's first steps here at a drug and alcohol rehabilitation centre that helped kick his addiction.
It took me 20 years to find the right treatment for myself.
He's been off drugs for nearly 2 years. Paul Fung's efforts have also paid off. He's not gambled in 7 years.
Life is a lot better now than how it was, because life was just, it was the pits.
On average, it takes people about 20 years to actually seek out help. And stigma is the main reason for that.
We label people very quickly, like, you know, you're a loser, you're a, you know, I don't like to use the word junkies and things like that, so we label them, not knowing the person.
Professor Dan Lubman is spearheading a campaign to get Aussies to rethink their attitude to people suffering from addiction.
So 1 in 4 Australians will struggle with an alcohol, drug or gambling problem at some time in their life.
Addiction is just one part of a person's story. The sooner we see the whole story, the sooner we can lose the stigma and get them the help they need. Together, let's rethink addiction.
Professor Lubman sees Paul and Baden's stories as proof that lives can be turned around.
How hard must it be when you know that you're struggling with an issue that the rest of, you know, your friends or peers or the community see as something that's self-inflicted? You know, that you're going to be judged if you admit you have a problem.
Baden says he wants people to look beyond people's addictions and appreciate their strengths. He still enjoys pushing his limits and prides himself on helping others as a drug and alcohol peer support worker.
It makes me feel as though everything I've been through isn't for nothing. I like life now. I love my life these days.
Oh, Melbourne hot sauce. Ooh, that.
The bomb.
That's got extract in it. That is really hot.
Baden's reconnected with old friends, and these days he gets his high out of chilies.
Cheers, man.
Once you push through that pain barrier, just the endorphin release, I was like, oh, wow. And I was hooked.
18 out of 10.
Yeah, but for a guy like you, it's probably a 4 out of 10. I know you're crazy with your chili. I reckon you'll really like that.
That is amazing.
Have I hit the mark?
You've done well.
Not long ago, Paul and his older brother caught up for dinner. The first time they'd seen each other in years.
I was just ready for the ammunition to come at me, and, you know, he just said, you're my brother and I love you. That was like winning gold. Good evening, everybody, and welcome to Question One Trivia at Surly's. Each and every
at 40, Paul has now found the confidence he lacked for so long, and it's on full display.
Which planet in the Milky Way has the fewest letters in its name?
Mars.
Mars is correct. Please add a bonus point. This is who I am now. So it's when people meet me now, it's like, wow, they can't believe. Well, this is proof in the pudding. It's happened. You know, there is transformation, it is possible, and anybody can do it.
Great, good work, right? Yeah, incredible that Baden's even with us to go through that transformation. If that story has raised concerns for you, support is available through the National Alcohol and Other Drug Hotline. The number is 1800 250 015. Lifeline is 13 11 14.